Everyone, how are you doing, beautiful souls? Hope you're all doing incredible, even in this uncertain period. Just be positive and find your passion so you won't get bored waiting for everything to turn to normal again. There are still many people outside there who suffer and who are poor, but I can still see smile on their face. And they never complain. So let's learn from them to stay gratitude and stay cheerful. Thank you for visiting my channel again. And please do not forget to drop your likes, shares, and hit the subscribe button for those who are new to this channel. To pass time, I'm going to create an inspiring yet funny video for you. There were two young girls came to the court, along with them a young boy who had promised to marry them. After listening to their story, the judge ordered them to be cut into half so both girls could have their share. "No!" shouted the first girl. "Do not spill blood. Let the other girl marry him." The judge didn't hesitate. "This man must marry the other girl," he said. "But she was willing to see him cut into two," shouted the audience. "Yes, let them be partner in crime." Boy. The boy and the other girl, they have same level of energy. Because they have lower energy, let them marry. Don't you believe the law of attraction? Like attracts like, and dislike attracts dislike. Agree or not? Another story. A young guy who fell head over heel with a young girl. But the problem is that he knows that this girl only takes into account those who can offer diamond and glitters. So, in order to get the love of his life, he decided to borrow his friend's cars, clothes, coats, money, shoes, and everything to support him to woo over her. They got married, and the girl found out the deception and was so angry, and then filed for divorce. The both of them suffered the loss. According to you, whose fault is this? It takes two to tango, right? It takes two to be partner in crime, right? He has free will. She does too. But both of them still in the lower energy. So it is their karma lesson for them. So what we learn from this story is that never love someone just because of money matter. Never take advantage. Because why? Because if you marry someone who is poor, but you are blessed, then your life will be prosperous. Both of you can work and then be successful. But you choose, even you choose to marry a rich man, a wealthy man in town or in city, but you are not blessed, and then he can go bankrupt. Money disappears. It is not eternal. So never choose someone based on money. Remember that. Because why? Karma is a bitch. It can find your address. Even you are hiding somewhere, it can find you one day. I'm going to sing a song. This is an oldies. So allow me to rest for a while to stabilize my breath. I love these dancing angels. They are so beautiful and so mesmerizing. My cheerleaders. No New Year's Day to celebrate. No chocolate car for candy hearts to give away. No first of spring, no song to sing. In fact, there's just another ordinary day. No April rain, no flowers bloom, no wedding Saturday within the month of June. But what it is something true, made up of these three words that I must say to you. I just got to say I love you. I just got to say how much I care. I just got to say I love you, and I mean it from the bottom of my heart. No summer's high, no warm July, no harvest moon to light one tender August night. No autumn breeze, no falling leaves, not even time for birds to fly to southern skies. No Libra sun, no Halloween, no giving thanks to all Christmas joy you bring. But what it is, though old so new, to fill your hearts like no three words. I just got to say I love you. I just got to say how much I care. I just got to say I love you, and I mean it from the bottom of my heart. This is devoted to my late brother, his favorite song. Let's continue. There is another story, but this is an infinite loop story. The story of Osiris and Isis is through infinite love. Osiris was the king of Egypt, who was very wise and powerful king. But his jealous brother tricked him and murdered him. His body was dumped into the river of Nile, expecting him to never come back alive. But her devoted wife Isis searched for the entire river day and night to find his body. Since his body And even his private part has been dismembered. So she used powerful magic to reconstruct and bring him back alive. But because he has already died, so he decided to return to the afterlife, but promised her that she will soon give birth to a son who would help her to bring back the throne of Egypt to prosperity. This is a sad story, right? But this is a proof of infinite love. A love that is thick to thick and thin, like when you are eating spaghetti noodle. You pull it and it cannot be cut off because the ties, their souls are intertwined even after death. Cannot be separated. Their souls are intertwined in infinite, everlasting. So, which one you choose? You want love based on material of this 3D matrix, or love based on two souls connected and then cannot be separated, and even one soul has returned to the afterlife, the other one still pining for his love? This is a great love story, a story that very romantic but very inspiring. Love that doesn't base on money or status or power, but pure love. Mother-in-law inspire more jokes than any other people on this earth. Lenin, the founder of Russia, once asked what should be the maximum penalty for a criminal. He replied, two mothers-in-law. A man once said, my mother-in-law called this morning. When I answered the door, she asked, can I stay here for a few days? You certainly can, he replied, but shut the door and say, sleep outside. Isn't he rude? Not all mother-in-laws are bad, right? My mother is the best mother-in-law, according to me. Once, while jogging, I overheard men's joke. One of them asked, what is the difference between mother-in-law and vulture? His friend answered, vulture waits when you are dead to eat your heart out. Very awesome joke, right? So if you are mother-in-law, be the wise one to clean up all mother-in-law's reputation and image. Because mother-in-law has been generalized and categorized as bad. Even the legendary Giovanni Ficlotti, who had 104 marriages, said that those marriages and mother-in-law were far less a problem than his 34 years in jail he received as a result of using fake identity to get married and remarry. Imagine, he enjoyed his prison time than being free with his mother-in-laws. Husband and wife are quarreling. Wife said, "You are such a fool and lazy. I couldn't live with you anymore." Husband answered, "What? You are the problem. You are such a nagger. And you are driving me insane. I was happy when I was single and stayed with my mother. She never complained and blamed me or even accused me of anything I didn't do." Wife replied, "Good. Let's talk about your mom. After living with you for 1 year, you only forced me to do anything from cooking, washing, ironing, cleaning, and do full-time job without any pay. Your mom has created a monster who enslaved women. I couldn't stand any longer. I want it out, and do not forget my share. Please, do not ever skip this. My share, or I will eat you alive." Husband replied, "What it has to do with my mom? Why you always blame anyone else unless yourself? No share for a damn digger like you, period." So if you are couples, please do not fight. Do not always argue and quarrel for something that is unreasonable. Because the purpose of getting together is to enjoy life, to be happy together, not to cross words and then fight. This is my message for you all there. Thank you for visiting my channel again, and please do not forget to come back next time. I'm going to make the continuation story of the rule of staying in a happy marriage. Remember, there are still 6 rules that I haven't finished because that time I was tired. As a reminder, do not take this too personal, since this is just meant to entertain you, but this is also an inspiration of how to stay and be a good housewife and mother-in-law. We all have our free will, but what we have to be mindful to use our free will in a good way, and then we can be the pioneer for other people outside there. Okay? See you. Bye-bye. Sending you lots of love and light. Lily.